Good morning, Vikings, and welcome back from February vacation.
It's been a pretty tough winter so far, with record amounts of snow falling in our area.
It's also the first winter some of our students have had their license and had to drive in the snow. What a year to start.
For most new drivers, the biggest concern of winter driving is taking it slow and knowing what to do if the vehicle begins to slide.
But in our first segment, Ben Volpone talks with some professionals who explain the other way to keep your car safe in the winter.
So you just bought your first car. Congratulations. But there's more to owning that vehicle than just driving it around to pick up your hot date.
All right. Yeah, what are the most common accidents caused from?
When people are driving too fast for conditions, you should always watch out for black ice. Even though in the mornings it might be a little bit misty or might have been a little bit dewy in the morning, it could get a frozen spot because of the frost. It'll get a black ice and you won't know it, and they're on bad curves and you'll just all of a sudden slide out of control. All
right, how can people be able to stop this from happening?
You need, on the driving conditions, you need to slow down and reduce your speed. Make sure you keep plenty of distance between yourself and the people in front of you so you have a good amount of stopping distance. You need to prepare your car earlier in the season, as soon as you possibly can before the winter starts, not right when it's not snowing, to get good tires on your car and make sure your car's ready. And you also need to be able to listen to the weather report before you leave in the morning, or see what it's going to be like in the morning, or check the temperature before you leave the house, or just check the ground on before you enter the car, see if it's a little slick, and you'll know about black ice.
What safety equipment should people have in their cars?
In your car before winter, you should have a blanket in case you break down and you're going to get cold and you don't know how long before somebody shows up, you can stay warm. First aid kit in case you happen to get in an accident or such, you can band yourself up or help somebody else out. If your car breaks down like we explained about in the middle of the road and your hazard lights and clearance lights don't work, you can put a reflective device out to be able to have somebody be able to see the car. You always should carry a flashlight with fresh batteries at the beginning of the season so you can at least see. You also should always make sure your car, before you leave on any journey or out, has at least a half a tank of fuel in your car all winter long, because if you happen to be going out and you get caught in a storm, you never know if you get stuck or if you can get in a traffic jam, how long it could take you to get to the next location.
Thanks for watching these helpful hints. Please take them to heart.
And always remember, before you leave your house, to have your emergency phone numbers ready, your police, fire, and local towing company, so in case you have a problem on the highway, you can have somebody to call.
From the Volpone family, have a happy and safe cold for the rest of your day.
Believe it or not, spring is almost here. The vernal equinox, which marks the official beginning of the season, is coming up on March 20th.
Spring also marks the beginning of course registrations for next year. It's the time when all Triton students get to choose the elective courses we want to take next fall.
To help you make your decisions, VTV will be running a series of videos over the next few weeks, spotlighting some of the choices we have.
Up first is Mr. Galante's engineering technology class.
With standardized tests like the MCAS and PARC placing an increased emphasis on subjects in science, technology, engineering, and math, Triton is staying in front of the curve by offering its students more and more classes to apply academic principles with hands-on learning. One of those offerings is Mr. Galante's engineering technology class.
So we had to build trebuchets that would launch a coconut 75 feet. It also had to use a 3D printed part that we designed.
Most of the students are engineering based. They plan on attending college for engineering. And they've had Mr. Castro for physics, or are in the process of taking physics right now with Mr. Castro.
I'm taking this class because I'm interested in engineering. Mr. Galante suggested that it would be a good thing for me to take. It's kind of different, but it'll prepare me for the future because it's a mostly like male-dominated field.
Engineering is pretty much nothing more than applied physics, and the students have the opportunity to take what they're learning on the whiteboard and actually apply it right here and actually see it come to life. And it's kind of exciting, you know, it's good stuff.
It's just really fun. It's not your everyday class where you sit down and take notes. You get to like problem solve in like a way you wouldn't in any other class.
We don't sit in rows and columns. You're up moving around. You're making mistakes and learning from your mistakes and constantly tweaking it and adjusting it and making it work. If you're even thinking about going into engineering, any form of engineering, this is a great problem-solving activity. I mean, the whole course is problem-solving. And it can be applied in many different avenues through the engineering fields.
Girls should definitely, like, try it out. It's fun.
There's an old saying, trust takes years to build, seconds to break, and forever to repair.
It's hard to put your trust in someone who lacks integrity, the quality of being honest and having strong moral principles.
Hallie Livingood created this next PSA to encourage us all to be people of integrity.
Don't want anyone stealing that. I found one.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Our final segment today is a short film created by my buddy Austin here.
Last year, most of you remembered my short film, The Mysterious Discovery. Well, this time, I boldly go where no one has gone before.
Sir, we have arrived at Tantalus.
Good. Move the ship slowly and watch out for the asteroids.
Aye, sir. Captain, enemy fighters coming in.
Take a phase of action. Fire! Send an emergency signal to Captain Pasek. He'll know what to do.
Yes, sir.
Kelvin.
They must be in trouble. Some enemy fires must have found them along the way. Everyone to your stations. We'll leave immediately. All decks, this is Captain Pasek. We're ready for takeoff.
We're out of space dock and ready for warp, sir.
Set course for Tantalus.
Aye, Captain. Course laid in.
Maximum warp. Punch it.
We shall arrive in Tantalus in 3, 2, 1.
Good timing, Lieutenant. Now let's go up the Kelvin. Fire.
The Enterprise.
I knew Captain Pasek would come.
Steady as she goes. Fire torpedoes.
Yes, sir.
Open fire on those last two fires.
Right away, sir.
Good shot. That'll teach those enemy fires a thing or two.
Kelvin the Enterprise. Your timing was perfect, Captain Pasek. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, Captain Vecto.
Job well done, Captain.
Job well done. Mr. Jamford, take us home.
Aye, Captain.
Thanks for watching this episode of VTV. I'm Keely.
And I'm Austin. Thanks for watching. Live long and prosper.
Oh my god, I'm nervous. I'm scared. Wait, are you gonna record it now? When do I go?
Whatever you want.
Alright, let's go, Austin.
It's been a pretty tough winter so far. Let me read that again. It's been a pretty tough winter so far with the Let me read that again. It's been a pretty tough.
You got this, Austin. I believe in you.
How we live in. How. To encourage us all.
But in our first, today is a short film created by. We suck. Please don't look at me. Is there gonna be bloopers?
Believe it or not.
Okay, you can't do that.
What did I do? I'm breathing. Okay, well, I am a heavy breather. Sorry. When is this gonna be on?
Live long and prosper. That's a Vulcan salute.
Done. It's a wrap.
Can we watch it?